Hello people, I'm AndyTheDead and I'm back with the final chapter of Windbound. We are about to find out what happened with Kara's people, but first we need to get to some exploring, so let's do just that. Alright, island up ahead, let's get to that. Just a couple of gore horns, sticks, grass and... Yeah, a few stuff. And the key shrine. Let's get to some hunting. Come to think of it, hunting might be a bad idea since I'm only equipped with, a stick spear. Managed to get one kill. Let's see if we can get the second. No, give me some bones or some arrows at least. Yeah, we got 4 arrows back. There we go. And some blinks. Yeah, let's get rid of you. Still, no bones. We got most of our arrows back, but yeah, no bones. Killed some big monsters and they dropped bones. Yeah, that's good. We need those to make some spears and some arrows and stuff. Right, I picked up most of the items I could find. Now let's get to that key. We fought them the last. The losses on both sides are inconceivable. Were we right in the end? No, you were not. Off to the next island we go, and when we get there, there is something I want to try out, or rather something I should have tried out, some chapters ago. And I think we can already see our next destination, so let's get to it. Right, made it to the next island. It's rather small, but it will do for now. First off, what is this? Just a storm's eye gem. Yeah, we might need that to repair our figurehead. So let's try this thing out. First, let's build a fire and let's upgrade it to a clay kiln. Right, and now we can craft new stuff. Yeah, this looks very, very nice. We could craft some armor, some arrows, metal spear, and a clay pot. Right. We're going to make a new spear first, and then we're going to make some metal arrows. There we go, 16 metal arrows. That's absolutely great, yeah. Now, let's get to exploring this little island here. Sticks, grass, mushrooms and clay were all the items I could find, plus a couple of trees that I can't chop down yet. Can't I make a metal axe? No. Doesn't look like it. Right, let's get moving to the next island and we might come back here. Right, so let's keep moving north. There, I think we already found something that way, and also... Yes, there appears to be something here as well. Let's go this way first. There we go. This is just a small island with, yeah, silk moss, sticks and whatnot. Still, let's explore. There it is, a stamina shrine. Right, let's go back to the boat and get the freak out of here. Now, I think the other island we saw earlier, the big one, yeah, it's right over there. And actually, this one looks to be giant. Yeah, let's go there. And I think I see two, yeah, of these little weird rock formations that have secrets. No, not on this side. Oh, this is dangerous. But perhaps maybe hit them with your spear, beat them with the brick. Yeah, we already saw this message. This is a giant shell. Oh, come on, you freaking crobster. A combination of crab and lobster, I guess. Alright, this place looks as if it's lots of fun. And there is something over there. Right, let me save real quick and let's get on with it. This doesn't look like a destroyed village, or rather looks like, yeah, a giant shell graveyard. Are we ready for this? Let's get the metal spear. Get out. Oh, did we scare it? Let's use the bow and arrows. That doesn't sound that good. No, that won't help. Right, let's leave this thing be. And we see a sleeping plane stalker there. Oh, that's a snake. There you go. Oh, another plane stalker. What do you have to say about my new spear, eh? There you go, and there's another snake there. Can I shoot it with an arrow? And I'm out of space again. I sure can. Dropped some items, and now we're ready to go. And there are also metal deposits on this island, so that's good. And I think we are close to making it to the top of this island, but yeah, nothing much is going on except perhaps this thing here. No, it's just a patch of dead grass. Yeah, nothing much going on. Snakes, plane stalkers, the weird mosquito thingies. And that's pretty much it, yeah. Right, made it to the top and we have a health shrine. I will not complain. Yeah, the walking was a bit too much, but at least we got something out of it. And when I say we got something out of it, I mean we get to use the glider. There we go, landed near this thing that won't show up to fight. Come on, show yourself. Or maybe don't. Oh, you hit like a truck, eh? You have a shitload of health. Right. There you go. It hit me one or two or three times, but now it's dead. And you just drop a Stormzai gem. I can't say that was worth it. And we're ready to go. I'm going to keep heading northeast so we can then circle back around. We also found one more of these places with, yeah, the jump across and the pots with the money. Let's go grab them real fast. So, money, arrows, and let's see what's over there. Just more money and arrows. All right, I will not say no. Now we'll head this way because, yeah, I see the key shrine over there. Oh, it's just a small island with a key shrine. That's all right, I guess. There we go. Let's get it. The tempest closes in. We have nowhere left to run. That's what you get when you anger the sea gods. Right, time to keep moving west. There, I can see the next shrine right over there. Let's get to it. All right, we're here. Let's get to exploring, collecting resources, and getting that key, perhaps. And would you look at that? It's a gloom harrow. Oh, I'm going to finally get my axe back. Also, there is something sleeping in that hole. Let's just hope it's... yeah, just a blink or whatever it was called. And my bone shovel has broken. I can always make a new one. Right, time to fight you, Gloom Harrow. Oh, and you go all sneaky sneak. Down you go. Yeah, we can finally make an axe again. Axe crafted, now we can chop down the trees and get wood to upgrade the boat and repair it. Oh yeah, we're going to need to do that. That also might mean I have to backtrack to the other islands, but... yeah, I'm not going to record that. Now let's keep exploring this one here. Things have gotten really, really red. Is that a bad sign? Usually it is in games. Right, let's keep heading this way. And another Gloom Harrow, yeah. I like this. Come on, you coward. Oh, there you go. And down you go. And we can build another axe. Yeah, thank you for this. We made it to the top. Let's get the key. We mourn our ancestral home, the gyre turns, turning future into past. Alright, we're one step closer to figuring out what happened. Or rather, confirming what happened. So, we made it back to the boat and... yeah, I have still this part of the map to explore and I have to backtrack to... 5 islands to get some more wood for the repairs and the upgrades. I'm going to keep exploring West Side and we're going to record whatever happens there. But yeah, the backtracking, I'm not going to leave that in. I think it's going to be even more boring than my videos already are. Right, found another island right here. Let's get exploring this place. Oh, and a planeswalker right off the bat. There we go, easy stuff. Oh, and I forgot, my pickaxe broke. So, yeah, let's make a new one. We need the Gorehorn crest, right? Just let me grab this one. Also, yeah, it would seem I can make the shrouded armor. Yeah, that's interesting. Let's do that. Oh, it looks a lot better. And of course, the main reason we're here for trees. Yeah, let's chop some down. And let's explore this side as well. Bamboo, trees, sticks, and yeah, stamina shrine. That's great. I don't think there are any more islands that we haven't yet explored, yeah. Alright, so I'm going to start backtracking to the other islands and collect all the resources I can, and I'll see you at, yeah, the beginning of the end. I've picked up all the resources I could, and now we made it to the causeway. So, yeah, let's start by building a few things. First, let's build a couple of fires. One that we turn into a clay kiln, and one that we will turn into a cauldron. Right, so here we can craft some potions that we need. Yeah, clay pots, range weapon damage, fire rate for range weapons, reduce damage by poison, walking and sprinting speed, stamina regeneration, and health regeneration. Okay, those are of interest. Right, so what can we craft here? I don't need an armor, I built a sneaky one. I could build a helmet. Yeah, that sounds interesting. And also, yeah, I should build as many arrows as I can. Before we do that, let's see if the boat needs any repairs. The main hull and the deck are okay, but yeah, the side hulls need a few repairs. And now let's try and build some armor for the boat. Yeah, we can build metal hull armor. That sounds nice, actually. Yeah, let's make some grass ropes. And now let's build the metal armor. There, much better. Now, let's see about those spikes. Yeah, I can build one for the main hull. Oh, but it would seem I can't use them with the armor. Alright, that's not to worry, I will build some arrows. There we go, now we can build a total of 8 metal arrows. Bringing us up to 15. That's quite good. Also, let's build 12 extra bone arrows. Also, it seems I can expand the hulls a bit, so yeah, let's do that as well. Oh, but now, yeah, the back part has lost its armor. Alright, no to worry. I think this is okay, I think this is okay. Let's try and tackle the final crossing. And the final mural. The secret to is raging. Then he does something, I don't know, jumps into the sea again. And the people are sailing towards the sun. Which is now fused with a sea creature, or something like that. Final crossing, acceptance. I called it from the first episode, this is about grief. Right, let's get moving. Alright, sea creature, do your worst. I will probably die. The music has, yeah, some sense of finality to it. And where is the Kraken this time? Alright, something is going on. Alright, first part, it's Jagged Rocks. Yeah, let's take this real there you go. Hello, sir. Something's going on. All right, maybe do the second part. Are you going to? Ah, crap. I thought it was going to hit me. Right, second part down. Doesn't seem so bad so far. Oh, and there we go. Throwing rocks. I also called that in the previous episode. Still haven't found any jellyfish or any sharks, but reefs, rocks and the giant sea creature, yeah, they are here. There go the jellyfish. I should be slowing down a bit. But where's the fun in that? Oh shit. Yeah, I made it through. Yeah, sorry about the silence, but I'm trying to stay concentrated. Just one more part? No, I don't think so. Actually, it's just this. All right then. Something's happening. Do I have to fight you now? It's a baby kraken. Lots of baby krakens, 5 to be specific. Did we find our people? Yeah, we did. Or at least the vessels, yeah. That's nice. And that was Windbound. All right, that was really, really interesting. I'm going to let the credits roll a bit sped up, and I will give my final verdict after the credits. All right, I always leave the credits in. Those people worked hard to make this great game, and yeah, at least the least I can do is give them the praise by showing the credits. Before we get the verdict, let me check something out. Right, so if you click continue on an already finished game, the game just drops you back here. Perhaps there is an extra mode, a play plus, new game plus mode or whatever. We'll find out. So, how was the game? Let's begin by saying that graphically it's a little bit dated, but still it's very beautiful and colorful, things that I like. I don't care much about super awesome graphics or whatever. I found it nice, even though it was a little it was failing at certain points. Sound wise, the sound effects were great and the music was awesome. It was pleasing to the ears, it was properly used when the monsters were around, that it gave you hints that they are there and all that stuff, and it was great. Sound wise, the game is great. Gameplay wise, controlling the character got very clunky at certain points. You may see this at the video, it's not Joy-Con drifting, it's not me being unable, or at least it's not only that, me being unable to control her, but yeah, it gets clunky at some points, what with the target lock and walking off some cliffs and all that, but still it's okay. The other gameplay elements were great. The survival stuff, although it felt a little bit lacking, it could use a lot more stuff to explore, stuff to build, stuff to do. I'm guessing this game is going to get DLCs, or at least make us able to download a mode that will allow us to play after the game is finished, you know, explore the islands and pick up resources and then reset the islands and all over and so on and so forth. Technically, don't play this game on Nintendo Switch. Just don't. It seems like a game made for this platform, for this console, but it fails. It crashes, I don't know, every time you're going to change an island. If it overloads, it crashes. I don't know, I said before, I don't know if this is a problem with my console or with Nintendo Switch in general, but this needs to be addressed by Deep Silver right away. Finally, is the game worth its money? Actually, for 30 euros that I bought it, it's absolutely worth its money. It has some level of replayability. The story is pretty nice. I mean, it's a little bit ambiguous, but it gets the point through. And yeah, actually 30 euros is a proper price for this game, but we still need content. We need a new game plus mode or something like that. Now, about the story. I said from the very first episode that this is about grief, and correct me if I'm wrong, but I still believe that. We had the five crossings named. The first one was Rejection, the second one was Fury, the third one was Covenant, the fourth one was Sorrow, and the last one is Acceptance. Those are the five stages of grief, only the names are a little bit different, which means denial, anger, bargaining, depression, and in the end, acceptance. But what was all this grief about? We saw that Kara and her people denied their gods, and they got angry, and I don't know, there was a war, and then the humans decided to leave. Or perhaps the game is trying to tell us that they moved on to the next world. And that was what Kara's grief was all about. And yeah, the giant Kraken monster thought she was worthy of moving on to the next world. Also, there could be a simpler explanation to all of this, especially if we take to heart all the promotion of the game and how the description of the game goes that Kara and her tribe were sailing along the Great Sea and she got stranded on the Forbidden Islands and she just had to bear witness to what happened to the people before her, just as a warning on what not to do. I don't know, it can be interpreted in a few ways and I'd like to hear your thoughts in the comments down below. So, that was Windbound. I'm going to keep playing a little bit just to see if I can find new stuff to do and new things to explore. I will see you all next game. Until then, stay safe and have fun.